fruit of the Spirit, self-control. So part of God's story is about the fruit of the Spirit, and it goes like this. The Bible says the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, and self-control. They're all good to have, and they all come from God. But for now, let's focus on self-control. When the Bible talks about self-control, it's more than watching what you say and thinking before you act. Self-control is when we trust God to help us know what's good for us and say no to things that aren't. Self-control is a skill God grows in us when we choose to consider Him and others before doing what we think will make us happy. Did you know it takes at least 80 days before watermelon seeds grow from a garden? Like watermelon, self-control takes a long time to grow. It's not something you can learn in one day. Like anything you want to get good at, you need to practice self-control every day. Now, it's not always easy to practice self-control, but with the help of the Holy Spirit, you can control your thoughts, words, and actions. And Jesus can help you understand how to make better decisions. Even if we know it's always best to show kindness to a friend or sibling, we don't always respond the way we should. The Bible tells us to practice self-control no matter what happens. James 1:19 says, "Understand this, my dear brothers and sisters, you must all be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry." And 2 Timothy 1:7 tells us, "God gave us a spirit not of fear, but of power and love and self-control." And in Luke 9:23, Jesus says, "Anyone who wants to be my follower must deny themselves, take up their crosses daily, and follow me." Now, when the Bible tells us to practice self-control by being slow to speak and slow to anger, it's not telling us to talk slowly or take our time getting angry. It's saying we shouldn't be so quick to tell others what to do or to blurt something out that might not be true or helpful. That's why we need God to help us control our actions. Self-control may look like not taking the last piece of pizza when you're already full, or letting someone else pick a game during family night, or not lashing out when someone annoys you. Remember, when we think about God and others before doing what will make us happy, we are choosing to be like Jesus, who practiced self-control when he carried out God's plan of dying for our sins. If Jesus hadn't practiced self-control, we would have to die as punishment for the things we do wrong. So when we practice self-control with our family and friends, we are showing God's self-control to others. Practicing self-control is part of what it means to have the fruit of the Spirit. Maybe you can think of an area in your day you need to practice self-control and ask God to help you. And as you experience God and grow in your faith, the Spirit can grow more self-control in your life.